to another video. Now, in this current video, we're going to have another practice problem for your Emsat physics preparation, in which we're going to be addressing a key concept based on a key problem from the Emsat physics examination format. Now, if you're an Emsat student, grade 12 student, preparing for your upcoming Emsat examination, make sure to take a look at the video description below, where we have links for our workshops and services that will surely help you prepare for your upcoming examination. Let's get right to the problem. Make sure that you have a pen and paper to take some notes and try to attempt the problem by yourself, and feel free to leave your answers in the comments section below in order to engage with our community and just to make sure that you are actually understanding the concept.
So in front of us right now, we do have a question straight from the mechanics section of the Emsat physics practice and preparation. This question is specifically targeting projectile motion. So a ball is thrown vertically up in the air and then caught again. Which velocity graph for the ball is correct? Now, what we're going to be doing in this case, representing the motion of throwing a ball in the air, then we're going to be selecting the best graph that suits the motion. Now, especially when it comes to this kind of question, you have to be very logical. Let's take a look right here. If you have a ball and you're going to be throwing the ball up in the air and the ball falls back to the same level it has been dropped from in the first place. Now, initially, once you throw a ball, you're going to launch it with a certain velocity. And once it gets to this point from the lesson of projectiles, the vertical component is going to be the same. So obviously we're going to have the velocity reversed, so the direction will be negative in this case. And one of the key characteristics of the projectile motion, once you get to the maximum height, always keep this in mind that the velocity is zero. So if the velocity is zero, let's say meters per second, we're expecting a motion in the following fashion. You throw something up, reaches a maximum height, stops for a bit, and goes down. Now take a look at the options that you have in front of you. Which one of those graphs best represents the following case? Let's start off with A. Now, if you take a look at option A, the velocity is increasing, then it starts to decrease. Now keep in mind, the slope for the velocity time graph is the acceleration. However, this selection A does not make sense, because once you throw something upwards, the velocity will decrease, then it reverts and falls all the way down. So this does not work, because it shows me that the velocity is increasing over time, which is not the case. On the other hand, question B, let's say, we have the same case as well. The velocity is going up, then all of a sudden we flip and we go down, we go up again. Now the slope is positive, so how would that look like in real life? The ball is going up, increasing the velocity, then goes back down, then goes up again. It's not realistic, it doesn't work that way. Let's go to option C. We're starting off with an initial velocity. So far it makes some sort of sense. Then the velocity is gradually going down, but in a curved fashion. Now this is wrong, because we're having constant acceleration due to gravity. The acceleration of gravity is 9.81 meters per second square, and the slope of a velocity time graph shows me, or gives me, the acceleration. So I'm expecting the velocity to be constant, and in a velocity time graph, if you have a straight line, the slope of this line is your acceleration, and in order to have a constant acceleration, it should be a straight line. However, we have a curve right here, so it means the acceleration is not constant. So this does not work as well. Let's take a look at the final selection. We're starting off with the velocity, correct? We've released the ball with an initial velocity. And as time passes by, the velocity is becoming lower, lower and lower, which is the case as we get to the maximum point. Then we have the zero mark, where the velocity is zero at this case. Yes, we have the following case where the velocity is zero. Then the velocity keeps on changing the direction now. We are increasing, but in the negative side. Yes, which is the case right here. We have the velocity decreasing as we go up, flips, then starts to increase as we go down, which is clearly represented by the following case. So if we're going to go through the choices, we have A, D, this is the answer, yes, 100% correct. Let's replay how we selected it. We started with an initial velocity. Then as time passed by, the velocity reached zero. And this is the only selection where we have the velocity reaching zero that makes sense. If you take a look at selection number B, the velocity did not reach zero, it just simply dropped and changed directions suddenly, which is far from the case that we have right here. So the answer for the following question is D.
We hope that you found the practice problem beneficial. Make sure that you subscribe to our channel and stay tuned for the latest updates. And we'll see you in the upcoming lesson.